This example, we are going to find the Dedekind and inverse acceleration equations for this planar robot with 2 degrees of freedom. After we obtain this equation, we are going to use these numerical values to check our theoretical results. So let's start with the direct acceleration. Based on this mathematical formulation, that we need to use the Jacobian matrix and its derivatives. So from the direct velocity solution and using the Jacobian matrix, we need to apply the temporal derivatives for any of these terms. Remember that when we apply these temporal derivatives, we use these joint variables, theta 1 and theta 2, as temporal variables. That's why when we apply this temporal derivative for any of these terms, we are going to use these velocities of these joint variables. Now, with this the derivative of the Jacobian matrix, we are going to substitute in our direct acceleration model. And then the last step is to do these matrix operations. Doing this and also doing some reductions, we finally obtain the direct acceleration equations. In this case, remember that we receive as an input the positions, velocities, and accelerations of the joint variables in order to obtain the n-effector accelerations. Now, for the inverse acceleration problem, we are going to use our formulation that is based on the inverse Jacobian matrix. So when we solve the inverse velocity problem, we already use the Jacobian matrix, and then we need to obtain also the inverse Jacobian matrix. Now, for the acceleration problem, with this inverse Jacobian matrix, we need to apply the temporal derivatives. So, similar to the Jacobian matrix derivatives, in this case, we need to apply the temporal derivative for any of these terms for the inverse Jacobian matrix. Remember that theta 1 and theta 2 are the temporal variables. So again, when we apply these temporal derivatives, we also use these velocities and position for the joint variables. Now, substituting in our mathematical formulation and doing the last matrix operations, we finally obtain the inverse acceleration equations. In this case, we need the velocities and acceleration for the n-effectors robot, and also the position and velocity of the joints variables. And then we can obtain the joint variables accelerations. Now let's check our theoretical results, first for the direct acceleration using these numerical values, and then substituting in our numerical and our theoretical equations, we obtain these numerical results for the n-effectors accelerations. And for the inverse accelerations, using these numerical values, we obtain these joint variable accelerations. In this final result, we also have this transformation for the degrees units over the square seconds.